Hello. Thanks for joining the session. As cloud vendors add support for commonly used databases, more and more organizations are looking at migrating or leveraging the cloud databases to reduce their on-premise infrastructure overhead and boost data to insight performance, especially when the analytics platform such as SAS Viya is on cloud as well. Today, we are going to talk about SAS connection and data access options for some of the Microsoft Azure data sources. I'm Kumar, Thangamuthu, part of Global Technology Practice, one of the data strategy leadership at SAS. I help SAS customers globally to solve business problems across various industries, offering data management expertise. Here's the agenda for today. We look at data access methods, five of the most used data sources, Azure Data Lake Storage, which is the blob storage source in Azure, HDinsight, Hadoop Data Lake Storage, SQL Database, MySQL Database, and PostgreSQL Database. Finally, we'll take a quick look at the possible data sources connection options for Azure databases. Azure Data Lake Storage, or ADLS. Here we are looking at creating a SAS via Cloud Analytics Service Library, or in short, CAS library to ADLS. And SAS library, or libref, at the same time. First and foremost, when an ADLS storage instance is created in Azure, it has to be ADLS Gen 2 for SAS to connect and access data. Other important parameters are the source type, which is set to ADLS. It is the SAS system defined type, so it has to be ADLS for this to work. Few Azure specific connection parameters, file system. This is analogous to a schema in RDBMS. Here it is set to data. Tenant ID. This would be the ID setup for your organization or a team in an organization, depending on whether that is just one Azure account for the whole organization or each team. And then the application ID. This would be an application registration ID in Azure. Typically, this would be set as which application from the organization is trying to access the Azure Data Lake Storage. And path, here is set to look from root with a backward slash. Also, a SAS library is created using libref, so traditional SAS data sets as well as in-memory tables can load it or save. If you look at the SAS log of the successful execution, this SAS Viya in memory has three nodes, one controller and two worker nodes, which now has a CAS library reference to the ADLS Gen 2 data storage in Azure. Now let's look at an example to save data to ADLS from SAS. Here we are saving the data to Azure Data Lake Storage in ORC, which is the optimized row columnar format using SAS ORC engine. We are utilizing the CAS, proc CAS util, to do this execution. Going from the top of the code, we are loading a SAS data set to in-memory cluster first, then saving the in-memory table to ADLS in ORC format. Key information here, the highlighted CAS out parameter. The file name should have .ORC to save the file in that format. As we look at the log, SAS ORC engine saves the class table, in this example, to ADLS in ORC format. Another point to note, the SAS ORC engine is independent of the support for ADLS. What that means is you can just create an ORC file output to be persisted just in a local path as well. Second, Azure HDinsight Hadoop Data Lake. This leverages SAS access interface to Hadoop to connect and access data from HDinsight Hadoop. URI is an important parameter here. This points to the Hive Server 2 in HDinsight. After a HDinsight cluster is created in Azure, this URI can be retrieved from the properties. Default is the name of a Hive schema we are pointing to in this example. Two environment variables has to be set. One to a local folder containing all the Hadoop jars retrieved from the HDinsight cluster that we have specified here using SAS underscore Hadoop underscore jar underscore path. And the other config XML files for the Hadoop cluster that we have specified here using SAS underscore Hadoop underscore config underscore path. SAS or Hadoop admin would use a SAS Hadoop phaser script. It's a Python script to extract these files from the Hadoop cluster to SAS. From the log, you can see this example uses SAS access to Hadoop with the engine parameter pointing to Hadoop. Third, we're looking at the Azure SQL database. Here we use SAS access interface to Microsoft SQL Server that is specified by setting source type parameter to SQL Server. The connection information is added to odbc.inf file as seen by SQL Server underscore DSN parameter, which is set to Azure SQL database in this example. Here's an example to save data from CAS in-memory cluster to Azure SQL database. This is similar to the ADS example that we have looked at. A couple of changes. Output CAS library is set to Azure SQL database, and the CAS out parameter set to just cars to save the data to a RDBMS table. Now, saving data to other two data sources, MySQL and PostgreSQL, are almost similar. So we'll just look at the connection information. Only parameter a user has to modify is the outcastlib, pointing to the specific data source. Like, for example, in this Azure SQL database, we are pointing to outcastlib azsqldb. That would be modified to point to the MySQL database library or PostgreSQL library for those specific examples. Other features such as SQL pass-through to Azure SQL databases are also supported here. Fourth, we're looking at MySQL database. Here we use SAS access interface to MySQL. This is specified by setting source type parameter to MySQL. The connection information is specified directly with host and user credentials. In this example, I have the global parameter commented. What that means is the CAS library reference to the SQL database only be available to the current session, current CAS session. Essentially, other users won't be able to see it. We have the source type set to MySQL, but the source type, other flavors on MySQL databases available in Azure can be accessed as well, such as MariaDB and MemSQL. Fifth, accessing Azure PostgreSQL database. The code is almost similar to MySQL, but the source type set to Postgres. By that, we are pointing the SAS system to use SAS access interface to Postgres to establish the connection. Other features such as SQL pass-through to PostgreSQL are supported here as well. In this example, we have specified the connection information on the credentials directly in the code here. We could also specify using an ODBC file as well. Here's a summary of all the possible databases in Azure that can be accessed from SAS using possible SAS access interfaces. If you have Teradata database in Azure, you can leverage SAS access interface to Teradata. If you have Snowflake in Azure, you can leverage the new SAS access interface to Snowflake. Now, SAS access interfaces to ODBC and JDBC can be used to connect and access data from virtually almost all the data sources. So, database-specific SAS access interface is recommended for optimal performance and additional features, such as SQL pass-through, which are specific to individual databases to execute the code, SQL code inside the database rather than pulling the data to SAS and then execute it. One of the advantages of using that is minimizing the data movement as well as boosting the performance of the whole data access functions. That's my presentation for today. Thank you all for joining us. If you would like to reach me, here's my email ID, kumar.thangamuthu@sas.com. I'm happy to chat with you. Have a nice rest of your day.